My sweater is emitting so much fuzz. So if you just see fuzz flying through the air this entire video, I am just very sorry in advance. Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. So today we are sitting down and I'm going to be going over all of my makeup empties from 2021. Every single solitary makeup product that I used up this year is in this box right here. You guys, this box is full. Full to the brim of makeup. I look down at this box and it brings me so much joy and it makes me so happy that I was able to finish this much makeup in the year. You guys probably can guess. I spend a lot of money on makeup. I do. It is my hobby. It's like my favorite thing in the world. So to see this box full of products that I used up and my hard-earned money put to good use, ooh, it makes me so happy. It brings me so much joy. So before we get started, don't forget I'm uploading every single solitary day this month. I'm super, super excited about that. If you like this video while you're watching it, please go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. It really does help my channel out. And other than that, if you're excited and you want to hear all about my makeup empties, you guys, it's so many. I'm so happy. Then let's go ahead and get started. So while I'm going over these empties, I'm not really going to be giving you guys mini reviews. If you are used to my channel and you watch my other empties videos, as I'm talking about the products, I try to give little tiny mini reviews. Sometimes I get long-winded and just talk and talk and talk, but I try to do mini reviews about the products, tell you what I thought about them. I'm gonna try not to do that with these products here because I have talked about all of them in my past empties videos. I'm gonna go ahead and have my empties playlist linked down below for you to check out in case this is your sort of thing. You like hearing about used up products because you guys, not to toot my own horn, but I feel like I'm pretty good about using up products. Like I do an empties video about once a month and it's usually like jam-packed full of items and I'm pretty proud of how many items that I am able to use up. So that would just make this video way too long. Also, if you watch my empties videos, then you've already heard all of these product reviews. I'm just going to try to maybe go over like yes or no, if I would repurchase it or if I have repurchased it. But mainly I just want to show you like what all I used up because I am proud and I want to tell someone. I figure maybe the easiest way to go about doing this is go in the order of application. So starting off with primers, I finished 5 primers this year. Were 4 of the 5 minis? Yes, but we're not going to talk about that, okay? I'm just still excited and pumped that I finished 5. So the first one I finished was the Hourglass Mineral Veil Primer. Yes, I would repurchase this. I love this so much. And I did repurchase it in a full size. I also finished up 3 mini of the Tatcha, the liquid silk canvases. 2 of them were like Sephora point perks that are like really, really mini. And then this one was the mini that you can purchase for like $22, I believe. Yes, I already have repurchased this. I purchased a full size in the most recent Sephora sale. This primer is bomb. If you have not tried it, it's bomb. And I also finished up a Smashbox Photo Finish Primerizer. This was a full size, so I feel extra happy and excited about that one. I love this. I have not repurchased it yet, but I would in the future. Then I finished up 4 foundations, 2 liquid, 2 powder. The first powder foundation I finished up was the MAC Studio Fix Powder Foundation. I love this foundation. It is in the shade N3. I did repurchase it and I'm about halfway done with the one I repurchased. And then I also finished up the Makeup Forever. This is their Matte Velvet Skin Blurring Powder Foundation. I had the shade R220. I did not like this powder foundation at all. I will not ever probably repurchase it ever. The first liquid foundation I finished up was the Fiona Styles Matte Finish Foundation. This is not available anymore for purchase. However, even if it was, I would not repurchase it. And then I also finished the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation Plus Concealer. I had the shade 00AA Ivory. Another one that I'm not going to repurchase. It just was very finicky on my skin. See, I'm giving mini reviews and I'm trying not to do that, but it was very finicky on my skin. One day it looked perfect, one day I hated it. So I used it up, not going to repurchase. Then I completed 3 concealers. All of them were full size. The first one was the Marc Jacobs Accomplice Concealer. I had the shade Fair 10. I don't think I would repurchase it. It was a stick concealer, so that was interesting in my collection. It was the only stick concealer that I owned at the time. And I think the only stick concealer I've ever tried, if I'm being honest. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I don't think I would repurchase this though. Then I finished up the Dose of Colors Meet Your Hue Concealer. I had the shade 03 Fair. I loved this. I don't really have any plans to repurchase right at the current moment because I just have a lot of concealers to get through, but I would repurchase this in the future. And then I also used up the Kosas Revealer Concealer in the shade 1.5C. I already rebought this. I love it so much, but I got 0.5 in. I can see myself getting this again next summer though, when I'm self-tanning and a little bit tanner, because this was a great shade match for me in those more summer months. So I definitely can see myself getting that shade again, but I also repurchased it already in my current shade because it's so good. Then I used up 4 powders, which I'm pretty proud of myself for that. Loose powder, I feel like, is very hard to use up. One of them was a mini, but that's okay. The first one I used up was the Hourglass. This is their translucent setting powder, their Veil translucent setting powder. Again, this was a mini. I really like this. I did get a full size of it. It's a very nice and not drying powder. I also used up the Cover FX Perfect Setting Powder. I had the translucent light one. This was my second compact I went through. This is a really amazing powder. It's a basic powder, but it's good. I don't have plans to repurchase it right now, but I definitely can see myself doing so in the future. I also used up the Anastasia Beverly Hills Loose Setting Powder in Vanilla. This is like my favorite loose powder, I think, ever. I already rebought it. I'm already using the compact I have now. It is just the most smoothing, perfecting powder. I have it on my face today. If you're curious about anything else going on in this face, I will have it all listed and linked down below for you. You know, I usually do that. Love this. Definitely rebought it. And then this is, I guess, not technically empty, but it's the Essence Brighten Up Banana Powder. There's like only a little tiny bit left, and I did go ahead and rebuy it. So I figured, you know what, instead of just scraping this little tiny bit left, I'm gonna go ahead and call it an empty and move on with my life and use the new one. This is a great powder. Already rebought it. I was a little surprised at how many brow products I was able to finish this year, but I finished 3 pencils and then 3 gels. So the first pencil I used up was my Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Definer in Chocolate. I had this baby forever. If you need a brow pencil to last you a lifetime, pick this up. I had it for like over 2 years. I would not repurchase this, I don't think. Then I also finished up the Huda Beauty Bond Brows in the shade Light Brown. This I feel like I went through very quickly because it is such a tiny, skinny pencil. However, that's like the reason why I loved it, because you can really get hair-like strokes. So I don't have plans to buy this again at this current moment because I just have a lot of brow products to get through. I'm like trying to slowly just churn my way through them, but I definitely would buy this again in the future. I did not purchase that one. I'm sorry, that one was sent to me in PR. I'm trying to think of anything else. I'm gonna try to let you know if anything was sent to me in PR or not. The Cover FX, this was sent to me in PR. This was also sent to me in PR. So everything else though, I have purchased myself. Yes. And then I also finished up the Benefit Precisely My Brow in the shade 3.5. Again, kind of like the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Definer. This pencil lasted me forever, like so stinking long. I was trying my hardest to finish it up and I was so happy when I finally did. I'm not going to rebuy this because it's a little bit thicker of a pencil, even though it says Precisely My Brow. It's a little bit thicker of a pencil and I just don't love that. So not going to rebuy this. For brow gels, I used up 2 of the Anastasia Beverly Hills Clear Brow Gel. I used up a mini and a full size. I really love this brow gel a lot. It just really sticks your brow hairs down and holds it like glue, but in the best way possible. I have repurchased it. It's up here waiting to be used. Again, tons of brow products to get through, so I haven't opened it yet, but so stinking good. And then the last brow product I used up was from the Beauty Crop, and this was their BFF Full Coverage Brow Mascara. I got this sent to me in PR. I liked this. It was very pigmented though, like very pigmented. You have to be super careful when you're applying it or it'll go overboard and like look a little cray cray. But I did enjoy this, but I'm not gonna buy it. I went ahead and used up 1 eyeliner, and that was the Benefit Roller Liner in the brown shade. It's an okay liner. I did repurchase it and I am using it currently. It's not the most pigmented liner of the bunch, which I like that because I don't like a super harsh winged liner. That's why I don't really use black anymore and I shifted more towards brown. But even with this being brown, it's just not that pigmented. So I guess it kind of depends what you're looking for in a liner. I personally like that. Again, I repurchased it and I'm using it again, but I don't know if everyone would. And then we got a whole bunch of mascaras to talk about, which thank goodness, because if you don't know, you're supposed to replace your mascaras every 3 months. Honestly, I keep mine open longer than that. I do. I'm guilty as charged. Even though your eyes are like so sensitive, I really probably should not do that. But I do. But anyways, I still used up a bunch this year. I'll talk about the couple of minis that I used up. The first one was the e.l.f. Lash Out Loud Volumizing Mascara. I did not love this at all. I don't think it really did much for my lashes, and I'm not going to repurchase it. I'm glad I ended up getting the mini to try it out, because it was a bummer, like a letdown. I was expecting to really enjoy it, and I did not. I also used up the Ulma Beauty Drama Bomb Extreme Volume Nourishing Mascara. This is the most scented mascara I have ever tried in my life. It literally smells like perfume, like you are putting perfume on your lashes. It's so odd. However, this made my lashes look bomb. Like, Drama Bomb is a good name for it. Kind of miss it, I'm not gonna lie. I kind of miss having this in my collection and using it. So I didn't really have plans to repurchase it, but now I'm like looking at it fondly and I'm like, maybe I should rebuy you in the future. I don't know, we'll see. As of right now, I don't have any plans though. And I used up a Kush mascara from Milk Makeup. I don't love this. I thought for a hot second that I did, but I don't. So I'm not going to get it again. I did have a full-size sent to me in Ipsy, but I actually ended up giving it away to one of my friends because I knew I wasn't going to use it. So it just doesn't do much for my lashes, sadly. I also used up a Marc Jacobs. This is their At Lash Lifting and Volumizing Mascara. I love this. So stinking good. I think this is the second mini I have gone through total. And then I ended up purchasing a full-size when they were having their big sale a couple months back. Again, not entirely sure what's going on with Marc Jacobs. I don't know if they're coming back. I don't know if they're like going away forever. I don't think so. But as of right now, I don't think you can purchase or pick up any of their items, which is sad because this is a really great mascara and I did buy a full size of it. And then the last mini I used up was the Hourglass Caution Extreme Lash Mascara. I used this up a long time ago and I kind of miss it. Like, I have another mini back there that I need to open up. And not that I need to open another mascara at this current moment because I have way too many open, but I feel like this is going to be my next one that I will end up using because this is an amazing mascara. Like, this is probably my third or fourth mini I've gone through. I haven't bit the bullet and purchased a full size yet because it's pricey, but such a good mascara. And then the rest of the ones I went through were a full size. The first one was actually a lash primer, and it is the Grande Cosmetics Grande Primer fortified with lash plumping peptides. I didn't technically use this one up, sadly. I just kind of had to put it in the empties because I had it open for like a year. I was looking at it and I realized, wow, you've been open for way too long and I do not feel comfortable putting you on my eyes, so I had to put it as an empty. I think that this really does something though. This is like the only lash primer that I've ever tried that doesn't make my lashes look clumpy, clump, clump. This actually made them look really nice. So this one was sent to me in PR, but I definitely can see myself purchasing this in the future. Then I used up a L'Oreal Bambi Eye Mascara. I didn't love this, but I think the reason why I didn't love it is because I purchased it in the brown shade because I was really wanting a brown mascara earlier in the year. But because I purchased it in the brown shade, it wasn't as pigmented. So then I had to layer it up, which then in turn made it clumpy. So I'm like, I feel like I would give this another try in a black one just to see how I would like it, but not anytime soon. And then I finished up the Pixie by Petra Large Lash Mascara. This was okay. This was sent to me in PR, so that's why I used it up. But it really wasn't, like, it wasn't the best mascara I've ever tried, but it wasn't the worst. It was just kind of forgettable. Like, I actually forgot that I used this up until I just pulled it out to talk about it. So yeah, definitely not going to purchase that one. Then I used up the Essence The False Lash Mascara Extreme Volume and Curl. Terrible. I don't even care that this is like $3 or $4. This mascara was so stinking terrible on my lashes. It did nothing and it flaked and it just looked so bad. Will not repurchase that ever again. Another one I'm not going to repurchase is the Thrive Cosmetics Liquid Lash Extensions. This gets so much hype. A ton of people love this mascara. I personally did not like it at all. And I paid like full price for this sucker. It's like $24, which is kind of expensive for a mascara. I just don't think it did anything. It clumped up really, really terribly on my lashes. I actually got set one in Ipsy and PR, but I'm going to give it to my mom because she wants to try it out because I just did not enjoy it. So I'm really hoping she likes it more than I did. And then the last one I used up was the Tarte Maneater Mascara. I'm unsure of why there's only one of them in here because I feel like I just always have this mascara open and I always use it. It is my favorite mascara ever. It's a mascara that I have on my eyes today. I just feel like it makes my lashes look so long and thick and curled and pretty, and it doesn't flake and it doesn't smudge. It is perfection. I'm already using a new tube and I am not kidding you. I have like two or three as backup. That is how much I love it. So yes, I will repurchase it forever. Then I used up a couple lip products, and then we've got setting sprays and we are done. So the first lip product I used up was from Wander Beauty. It was their Lip Retreat Oil. I liked this, I did. It was in my project pan, the 20 products I wanted to use up by the end of the year, and I was pumped that I was able to use it up. This one was sent to me in PR, I believe through Ipsy. I liked it, but not enough to ever really repurchase it. It wasn't moisturizing enough. Then I used up the Biossance Squalene Rose Vegan Lip Balm. I did not enjoy this at all. This was also sent to me in PR. It made my lips so cracked and chapped and just awful. I don't recommend it at all. And then the last lip product I used up was a lipstick. A lipstick. I used up a lipstick. I was super proud of myself. I used up the MAC. This is their satin lipstick in the shade Brave. This is one of my favorite lipstick shades ever. I've been through like 4 or 5 bullets at this point. It's a beautiful shade. I don't have plans to repurchase it right now, but I definitely can see myself doing so in the future because it's just a really pretty berry shade. And I used up whole lipstick. You guys, that doesn't happen very often anymore for me. I used to just fly through these and I would use up one at least once a year. And now I just have a plethora of lipsticks to choose from. And I don't go through things as quickly as I used to. So I was really excited when I finished this up. All right, and my last category is setting sprays. I used up 8 setting sprays this year. 3 of them were minis and then 5 of them were full size. The first mini I used up was the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray. Love this setting spray, so stinking much. Already repurchased the full size and I'm like more than halfway done with that one. I'm gonna need to repurchase another full size coming up very soon. I also finished the Fenty Beauty What It Do Mist. This is such a beautiful mist. I really do love this. I also repurchased a full size and I've also gone through like half of that one. And then the last mini I finished up was the Benefit Professional Super Setter Long Lasting Setting Spray. This was just like okay to me. I liked it while I was using it, but it was a little bit forgettable. I don't really have plans to repurchase it right now. I mean, it was an okay setting spray, but I don't think it really did a whole lot. I liked it. I did love it. I just kind of honestly forgot about it. Then I used up a Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. I was gonna say I love this mist, but I don't really love it anymore. I used to love it a lot. So I'm just trying to like run through the stash that I purchased like a year or two ago. I do currently have one that I'm trying to use up now. I like it, it's a good one. I can see myself maybe repurchasing it in the future, but I don't have plans to right now. Then I finished up the CoverFX High Performance Setting Spray. I'm not going to rebuy this. I did not enjoy it at all. It was very alcoholy and a little bit drying. And also it just jetted out at my face so hardcore and left those dots everywhere, which is just very annoying. So I definitely am not going to rebuy that one. I also used up the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Acid Setting Mist. This was a beautiful setting spray. I have not repurchased it and I don't know why, because every time I see it on sale, I tell myself, Emily, you should rebuy that. You like that setting spray a lot. And then I just never do. So I'm sure I'll eventually pick another one up, just I haven't quite yet. I also finished up the ColourPop All-Star Face Setting Spray. I would repurchase this if I could, however I can't. It is no longer available. Rest in peace. And then the last one I finished up was an Urban Decay D-Slick. I love this setting spray. I have been using it for years. Years and years and years. It's a setting spray I use today. I have one currently in my stash, and when that one's out, I will definitely repurchase this. So just a little bit of a recap. I finished up 5 primers, 4 foundations, 3 full-size concealers, 4 powders, 1 liquid eyeliner, 3 brow pencils, 3 brow gels, 4 mini mascaras, 6 full-size mascaras, 3 lip products, and 8 setting sprays. I feel so good about that. I know I said this in the intro, but looking down at all this makeup that I finished up makes my heart so happy. Some of it makes me sad because some of it's not available anymore, or I just really genuinely loved it while I was using it and I just haven't repurchased it yet, but I feel good. Let me know down below. Have you used up a lot of makeup this year? I wanna know. I'm nosy. I wanna know if this is like considered a lot to you, or if you're like, Emily, you're a chump, and I used up like twice the amount of makeup as you. I wanna know down below. I feel like makeup is hard to get through. Skincare, hair care, that kind of stuff. I can usually fly through that in like a month or two. But makeup is hard because I have so much. I've got way too much to choose from. So the fact that I used up all this, I just feel so, so good about that. If you made it to the end of this video, thank you so much. You're awesome. I love you. Please subscribe if you have not yet. And I will see you tomorrow in my next video. Bye, guys.